I'm back. I'm better than ever. It is Friday, and I'm so excited to be here with you guys today because we have another great workout. Warm-up, goal, 2 rounds, 25 seconds of the plank walkout. What you're gonna do is, start in this plank position, you're gonna walk your hands out a little bit and then walk them back so your wrists are under your shoulders. Then you're gonna walk your feet back. And then you're gonna walk back up. So I'm trying to activate my core. Each time you do it, you're trying to go a little bit further until eventually we get our nose all the way down over the course of a couple rounds, 25 seconds if you can. After that, we're going to do 20 jumping jacks. Everyone knows the jumping jack. Pretty straightforward. And then we have 15 air squats. So we need to see how these legs feel. We haven't squatted in a few days, which is fine. Air squat, plain and simple. After that, we have groiners. I love this one. Take a step forward, reach, get some trunk rotation. We'll alternate. We're gonna do 5 each side. 25, 20, 15, and 10 is the rep scheme for 2 rounds. After that, we get a little bit of barbell work we're gonna do as we continue on some of that barbell progression warm up. No major lift today, which is fine. If you guys wanna do it, you can. We're gonna go into some intervals after that. So, without further ado, let's do this. 25 second plank walkout. I'm gonna look at my clock so I know kind of where we are. We're gonna start in 2, 1, and go. So we're walking out with the hands. We walk back. This is nice and controlled. Don't have to rush this. We want to activate that core. We walk back up. Walk out again. Back. Walk back out. Back up. Okay, and let's stop there. Let's stand up.
20 jumping jacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Let's do 15 air squats.
Go into our groiner stretch. Take a step forward, right arm up, good stretch, and back. You're gonna place that foot next to the hand completely flat. I drop my opposite knee down. You don't have to, but it gives me a better stretch. It takes some pressure off my trunk as I rotate. So, something I like to do. You guys can freestyle on it. 5 in, we're going to 10.
Okie dokie. Let's get into round 2. We're gonna do the plank walkout.
I'm gonna check my timer. I'm gonna start now. We're going 25 seconds. Walk those hands back. Tiptoe those feet back. Try to get a little bit lower as your core gets activated. Okay, stand up for jumping jacks.
20 reps, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Good, let's do 15 air squats. Two more.
Okay.
Let's do our groiner stretches.
10 groiner stretches. Number eight. A couple more.
Daddy, I can't do squats because I hurt my knees.
You did?
Yeah.
Okay, guys.
I want you to hang out real quick here and go into some mobility. You're just going to do like a low dragon position stretch where you put your armpit onto your knee. And I want to mobilize this ankle real quick. So I want you guys to jump into this and listen to me as I explain the next section. And then we're gonna switch legs. So you guys hang tight there. Let's do about 30 seconds on the left leg, switch. You'll do about 30 seconds on the right leg. That'll just help open up with some mobility. What we have next in this sequence is, on Fridays, we've been doing 7 minutes of barbell cycling work just to work on positions and get you guys re-familiarized, maybe if you've had a little bit of downtime being outside of the gym, with the barbell movements. So we worked on snatch the last couple weeks. This week I wanted to work on the clean position and then go overhead for some strict presses and just kind of see how we felt if you guys were able to do those tempo Arnold presses with us the other day. So just kind of get some of that lactate out and move those muscles, get loosened up. We don't need to add any weight to this. Check Wattify, there's a complex if you guys have an opportunity and you want to add weight today that you can go to. We're not gonna fly into that today, but it is something if you have weight at home you can do. So we're gonna start with an RDL. So I'm gonna grab my barbell. I'm gonna take a clean grip this time. So I'm about a thumb and a half distance apart. If you wanna throw your hip grip on, you're more than welcome to. All right, you're gonna stand up nice and tall. You're gonna kind of unlock those knees, push the hips back, we're gonna go to about mid shin, and then back up. So spine stays nice and rigid. It's very similar to what we've been doing, except for now we have the clean grip instead of that snatch grip. Once we do seven there, we're gonna go to seven muscle cleans. So I'm gonna pull up, fingers open, elbows through and high, and each time I wanna go faster and faster. If the barbell's a little heavy for you, you need to add a little bit of hip to it. I'm not mad at you, but I want you to try to keep four fingers on the bar and work on mobility in that position. Once we get done with those, we're gonna go to a front squat, seven reps. We haven't got a lot of front squats in. Once we get done with our seven front squats, it's seven strict press. Okay, I want you to work on speed through the middle on this one. Straight up. Notice how elbows are slightly down and out. Okay, straight line, head back. And then I press through and up overhead to lock out. All right, and then once we finish that, we're gonna bring it down on the back. I'm gonna go into a good morning, unlock knees, push hips back, feel some tension in my hamstring, and then activate glutes on the top. So if you look at me from the side, it's just the push back, back nice and rigid, and then up, squeeze glutes. We're gonna do this for 7 minutes until we're dripping sweat. It's okay to set the bar down after the set, but I want you to try to get seven reps of the five movements in before you rest as we've been doing the snatch. So let me restart my timer. Actually, we'll let it roll up here, and I'll go with the 10-minute mark. So hopefully you guys are mobile, wrists are feeling good, got some stretches in, and let's go ahead, grab that barbell, stand up nice and tall, and make sure that you guys are ready to rock and roll. I'm gonna press those feet through the ground, nice through point of contact, and here we go. Seven RDLs, nice and smooth. Remember to flex those quads at the top. Squeeze your glutes as you activate. Okay, we're gonna go to a muscle clean. Each time, it's faster and faster. The elbow. Notice how the bar comes straight up my shirt. remember to try to keep four fingers on the whole time. And we're gonna go into seven front squats. Set, feet are under the hips. Seven, strict press overhead. Good, bar on the back. Seven good mornings. Spine nice and rigid, feel that stretch in the hamstring. And then really explode up and activate those glutes. Good, bar goes down, shake it out. And you can see that took us 2 minutes to go through, so we should be able to get 3 rounds in like we've been doing. If you want to speed it up, that's fine, but I want you to feel these positions and feel these movements while you're doing it. Here we go for round two. A couple more. Good, two muscle clean. Really, elbows through fast. Bars resting in the fingertips. Good, we're gonna go into seven front squats. Set, seven press. And good morning. Getting a little bit burned there. You're supposed to. We're doing 35 reps on the barbell. Without setting it down. So I'm burning, I'm sweating, and no weight is on the bar. Control these good mornings. You don't want tons of pressure in the lower back. Want to feel that in the posterior chain. And let's set it down. Take it out. Take those wrists out, it's perfect. Probably gonna be able to get one more round in. Staying consistent, clear shoulders. Yeah, yeah, for sure. The best dressed CrossFitter just left. Are you done with your warm up? Okay. All right, let's do one more round here, guys.
No rush.
Here we go. RDLs. Remember, we are working positions. No reason to rush these. No reason to add weights or warm up. Really press through the ground to a muscle clean. Good. To our front squats. Set, press. And let's do some good mornings. 7 reps. Now, if you guys have 1 or 2 dumbbells, it's probably been kind of tough. But you can do these with dumbbells as well. Do this complex with a single or a double. Set it down. Good. We still have 30 seconds left. We'll go ahead and wrap it up. Maybe a couple of you guys are wrapping up at home. And we'll move our barbells out of the way. Check the complex that I have for you guys in Wattify. And if you guys can build up on that over the course of the sets, good on you. If you don't have weight, don't worry about it. We've got this nice little interval session we're gonna jump into next. So what we have for you guys today is 3 rounds. We're gonna start a new round every 7 minutes. So the target time for these rounds is around 5 minutes. We'd like you to get a couple of minutes rest in, but we'll give you some additional time in case the run gets slow or in case you need to take some breaks. If you get it done faster, it's great. Keep pushing, keep challenging yourself to keep the intensity up. It'll be fantastic. So we're gonna start with 15 dumbbell deadlifts. Love the deadlifts. We've been doing some tempo things over the course of the last couple weeks. Not this week, so we're gonna throw them in the workout. Got 2 dumbbells here. Okay, top of the dumbbell heads are gonna touch the ground. And we're right back up. Spine nice and rigid and stand. You only have 1. We've been doing goblets, okay. 15 repetitions. All right, if you want to do it with a single, okay, and you want to hit, let's say, 8 repetitions on each side, more than welcome to give you 16 total, get an extra rep, a little extra credit, fantastic. After that, we're gonna go to 20 hang dumbbell power clean and press or jerk. I'll probably be using the push press on this, it's 10 each arm. You guys are gonna have 1 dumbbell between the legs, it's gonna come to the front rack and overhead, okay? You've got 10, nice little rhythm under it and straight up. 10 on one side, 10 on the other. So hopefully you have a dumbbell. If you have a kettlebell, I don't have any here with me, but it's gonna be clean to the front rack and press overhead. You don't have to go to the ground with those. If you guys have a barbell at home, whew, you got 20 clean and jerks. Keep the weight light. If you look in the Wattify system, I've kept it at 75 and 55 pounds to keep you moving. If you've got a little bit more weight, should be okay. We then have 25 sit-ups. So I'm gonna use my dumbbells for my anchor today. I'm gonna anchor my feet underneath. And what we're gonna do is, we're gonna come all the way down, up, and touch the dumbbells today, okay? If you're a butterfly sit-up person, then we just butterfly, put the feet together, shoulders touch the ground, and you're coming up to touch the feet with that for 25 repetitions. After that, you guys have jumping split lunges. So the jumping split lunge is pretty ballistic, and then going into the run makes it tough. Just gonna lunge side to side for 30 reps. Make sure you're standing all the way up. If you need to just go into a reverse lunge, legs have been kind of sore over some of the workouts that we've done over the course of the week or so, you go to a reverse lunge, get a little cushion underneath your knees, that would be great. We're gonna finish it with a 400 meter run. I'm gonna use the assault runners today instead of the true form. If you guys have an opportunity to go outside and run, it is a gorgeous day today, warm, and hopefully you guys can get outside and enjoy that fresh air. If not, you have a 400 meter row or an 800 meter bike as we've been working off distance right now, set of calories to keep it pretty consistent across the board. So remember, our goal is to get it done under 5, get a couple minutes rest so we can go again. Let's do it. You ready to rock and roll?
What are you doing?
Crank your music up.
Let's do this thing.
Two, one, and go.
One.
One more. Twenty-five sit-ups.
Going to our split lunges. Okay.
Good morning, guys. Right where we want to be. Right around that 5 minute mark.
How much are we doing here?
Huh?
What should we do?
It's every 7 minutes.
No, on the rope.
400. So you're trying to push this run. Go ahead and push it, guys. You're going to get a couple minutes of rest, or at least 90 seconds. Thank you.
Good first round.
I'm on the camera. Come here. Look at her. Hey, Cruz. Come here for a second. Can you help her out? Let's get ready to go, guys. 50 seconds. We're going to start with the deadlift. Crazy.
So we keep that pace up there.
30 seconds. Get ready. Maybe we should do 5 rounds. You go in 15 seconds.
Round 2. Let's get ready to go.
8 seconds. 3, 2, 1, go. Ten each arm here. You got a barbell, you got 20. The barbell is from the hang. Just a couple more. Five sit-ups. Yeah. 30. Let's get it. Oh my goodness. Woo!
Go run.
Really gonna have to fight the pace on this one. You wanna slow. Get those legs heavy. Try to work on turnover. Relax. Pick it up as you go. Final round. Good. Got a minute 15 to recover, last round. Minute to go. 1 minute. Okay. I feel like the recovery is adequate. Hopefully you guys are getting enough to keep moving. Feel pretty good. 30 seconds to go. I can feel it Fridays. Six sessions in a row. I can feel it. It's going 20 seconds. Seven sessions in a row. 10 seconds. Get ready, guys. Last round. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go. Really important that you keep your back nice and straight. Bend at the knees if you hinge back. Yeah.
my sit-ups. Split lunges, last round. Last one, let's try to pick it up. Come on. Pushing if you're finishing up. Stay with the old little seven. Did it 25. Guys, 40 seconds. 20 seconds, guys. This is it. Final push to get it in. 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time. Good job, guys. I hope everybody had a really good workout today. Remember, if you have some weight and you get those complexes in, go for it. Everyone else, this is what I want you to do. Take 5 minutes to go for a walk. Cool down, get your heart rate down. When you guys come back, and you can rewind this back, we have some mobility drills we want you guys to go through. So I want you to go back to that low dragon. I want you to mobilize that ankle by applying that armpit right onto the knee. Try to keep the heel flat. I want you to hold this side for 1 minute. Once you guys get done, obviously, we're gonna go to the other side and hold 1 minute on this side. Then, from here, we're gonna do a half front split. So I'm just gonna roll this leg back, straighten it out, hip stays above the knee, and I'm gonna reach. This is gonna get into the hamstring a little bit more after all those deadlifts, some of the barbell work that we did today. You'll feel your lower back as well. So we've got a minute hold in that half front split. Go back to the other leg, you can go right or left, doesn't matter to me today. We'll go another 1 minute on this side. So we're into 4 minutes at this point. Then we're gonna go into a twisted cross. I wanna open up the pec and the shoulder a little bit more, work on the low back. So you guys are gonna come into a left arm out to the side, right arm presses off, you're gonna rotate over. I want you guys to hold each side here for 1 minute. Now we're up to 6 minutes, okay? Then we're gonna do 3 minutes. We're gonna end it here in a 3 minute standing straddle. So we're gonna go 4 to 5 feet apart. I want you to put your hands down. If you can start to widen your legs, go for it. But it's 3 minutes in that hold. That's gonna mobilize you guys out for about 9 minutes. If you wanna spend more work, go for it. We will see you tomorrow, Saturday. What a workout is going on Saturday. So hopefully you're ready. We'll see you then.